Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create the custom web view, okay, in MIT App Inventor. So we all know that we have one web view, but this web view has some limitation. That's the reason we should use the custom web view. So click on start new project, and my project name is web view project. I'm going to use here one extension that is called custom web view. Okay, so what I will do here, I'm going to download the extension. That's my screen here. So let's go to that link. I will give you that link in the description, okay? And this is called the custom web view, okay, AIX file. So we need to just download this file like this. Now go to the MIT App Inventor. In the left side, we find the extension option, and we just need to upload that extension. Simple as that. Import, choose file, just upload that extension and just wait some seconds to upload it. And you'll see that just, and in the middle, you'll find the custom web view. This, just drag and drop this. Okay, done. Now, in the left side, you find the layout and just drag and drop the layout. You can, drag and drop the any layout. So I'm going to choose the vertical arrangement. So I'm going to use here the width and height is fill parent like this. And it's simple. Now let's go to the block section. Okay. And we just need to write a basic code to create a custom web view. We all know that we have our extension, we have our web view like this web view, but this web view have some limitation, like you can't have the permission. Okay. Easily, and a lot more, issues this have. So to extend the functionality of your web view, that's the reason we are using a custom web view. Okay. So how we can use it? So let's go to the block section. And we need to initialize and we need to display that that web view. So how we can do this? So we are going to use your screen initialization. Once the screen will initialize, it means whenever someone open our app. So let's click on the custom web view, and you will see here the create web view, okay, option. It means you can create the multiple web view using one extension. Yes, it's possible. So you'll find the create web view option, this one. Just drag and drop this. And you'll see here, we need here two things, container and ID. Container is something where we need to store something, right? So that's the container. So we have the container is vertical arrangement that we have just added here in the design. So that's our container where we display the web view, okay? So let's go to the block section and click on the custom web view here like this. And sorry, the vertical arrangement, and just drag and drop that vertical arrangement. And what is the ID? ID is something, this is the unique custom web view. So you can define any ID, but that should be the numeric value. So I'll just display a numeric value to 1. That's it. But we need to set that web view also. So click on the custom web view and we'll see the set web view. So you can see here, this is the, you know, alphabetically arranged like C, D, E, F. So we know the set web view. So we know that is in the downside, like, okay, just set web view. This one, just drag and drop it like this. So which ID we need to set? So it's simple, is we know that is our 1 ID. Now we need to add some, you know, URL to display that, because that's the reason we are using our web view, okay, because we need to display some URL. So that's why I'm going to use again custom web view, and you'll see the go to URL option. So G is like go to URL, and you will see here go to URL, this one. Just drag and drop this, and I'm going to use a text field, and just, and you can copy paste any URL. So I have the coding bus URL like this. That's it. So that's the use of custom web view. So now wherever you open this app, so the coding bus website will show you. Okay. So let me just open this. Okay. Let me just scan this. Let's just scan AI company. So you can see that's the website that is loaded, right? I don't know. You can see it. This is the website that just loaded. Okay. So using this, the reason is you can get easily any permission using this component. Like if you want to get the video calling permission or audio permission, because in few days we are going to create one amazing video calling app, okay? So we need this extension, okay? So this is the use of extension, and there are a lot more uses of this extension. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.